Hi everyone, welcome to the dark side of YouTube. I'm your host iSassin, also known as Minho Walmart version. In this occasion I'm gonna throw my opinions on new record by one of the biggest boy group from South Korea, SHINee. Without any further ado, let's get started. SHINee, K-pop boy band SHINee has repackaged and re-released the album Don't Call Me, and added three new songs. The new album was named Atlantis. Three new songs that have appeared in Atlantis are entitled Area, Days and Years, and Atlantis. All three songs have joined forces with his previous hit, Don't Call Me. The re-release of SHINee's seventh album is only 2 months after its initial release. The Atlantis album has been released digitally on April 12th. While the physical version is April 15th. Atlantis, there are few things more satisfying than a pop group in their element. With age comes clarity, and SHINee are at a point in their career where they know their strengths. They can tackle pretty much any genre and make it their own, i.e., Don't Call Me, but no one does bombastic electro-funk pop like they do. Much of their newest album proves this, and now it has a title track to match. Atlantis is undiluted, unbeatable SHINee, and a formidable force in a year that has already delivered its fair share of classics. First unveiled as part of the group's Beyond Live concert last weekend, Atlantis has been swimming around my mind for days. It was love at first listen, and its simple, descending hook latched onto my memory like a pleasant dream. Hearing it again in full studio recording is an overwhelming experience. K-pop thrives on a larger-than-life sense of drama, but the actual music rarely sounds this immense. Atlantis wastes no time, laying down tense bass guitar as a prelude to its powerful verse. The instrumental has the movement of rolling waves, and provides a sparse backdrop for SHINee's unadorned vocals. Few K-pop groups could away with an arrangement this revealing, but SHINee's talent has long since been proven. From here, the song opens widescreen and never looks back. Synths and percussion rush in all at once, joined by icy strings and gorgeous vocal harmonies. Atlantis's chorus further expands this sonic palette, adding extra rhythm guitar and a propulsive electro throb. SHINee's vocals are layered in the towering blend that's come to characterize so much of their music. But although this might be the song's centerpiece, the entirety of Atlantis is performed with incredible intensity. Where most tracks might climax in a single, well-placed power note, Atlantis rattles off several of them as casually as handing out candy on Halloween. It's SHINee doing what they do best, and once again reaffirms their status as one of K-pop's most legendary groups. Area, along with its new tracks, Atlantis has shuffled around its original sequencing. This is an interesting move, and some of the choices make a ton of sense code directly after Atlantis. Wow. But, a song like Area, Gaten Jolly feels better suited to the second half of the album, which is moodier and more subdued. Wherever it's placed, this is still a great track. It carries a sense of melancholy at odds with the rest of Atlantis, but the instrumental grooves on addictive percussion that fits perfectly with the funkier offerings surrounding it. Area thrives on its vocal performance, which wafts in like a gentle breeze. But, this breeze has bite. The wistful falsetto during the chorus is a testament to SHINee's range, and evokes emotion even as its twisting melody thrills. The verses are less memorable, but fueled by nuanced performances that elevate the material. Then, as Area approaches its final chorus, SHINee are echoed by muted brass that injects a new texture to the already tactile track. Compared to a blockbuster like Atlantis, this would be considered subtle. But, it's far from dull. Days and Years is a fine track, but I think the producer not really mastered the instrumental well. Some weird noise synced with the arp and those beginning chord progressions. SHINee performed this single with Hawaiian-type beat. A mix between Hawaiian Latin cumbia instrumental. Overall, this repackaged album is fine. I bless this album 7 out of 10. Feel free to comment down below what's your takes and perhaps you can recommend me track or album that I can review in the next video. Hit the like or dislike button to rate this video. Hope you enjoy the video, thanks for watching, and please don't cry. I'll see you in the next video. Bye nerds.